to war. Ever since I've been in this place, we've been warring. Bishop is a Nehemiah man. Build up things. Build it. But yet to see he has his weapon in his hand. So he taught us to do this, no matter what the situation is.
Whenever you go to the doctor,
The doctor diagnosed me with something else. I said, I don't want to go back to the doctor. I said, I don't want to speak the word. But then what I said, I just had to find all them side effects on the medication. So you have to go into this spiritual warfare. This is spiritual warfare going on. We've been warring. But now we got to find out how to defeat the enemy. Your enemy attack you every time when you get ready to advance in the ministry. We've seen it happen here a lot of times. So how can we defeat this enemy?
You must remember that Yahweh is with you. Joshua 1:9. Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thy dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou goest. 2 Corinthians 5:7. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Ephesians 6:10. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might.
So you have to remember that Yahweh is with you. You know, don't think about yourself. Think about Yahweh. He told Joshua. Joshua was a warrior. Are you not a warrior? I know I'm a warrior. I might get through, but I'm still standing. You know, you still stand. You might get beat up, but you got to sit back and kind of retreat. And you gotta be strong in the Lord. And sometimes you might cry. Then you said, just a little baby, you know, try to think that you're weak. But I came across where we said, Yahweh here. Answer to your cry. He listened. See, it's okay to cry, but you gotta get back up. Okay? You gotta get back up. And also, it says, you walk by faith, not by sight. I thought about when Israel was on the battlefield with King Saul and the Philistine. The Philistine was on the mountain, and Israel then was on the mountain, and nobody down in the valley. Every day, every morning, every evening, there was a Goliath. He would rise up early in the morning just to taunt God's army. He would taunt him. But so we had to be like that. What are they saying about my God? Like you be on the job. They talking about God, your God. Our God, what you gonna say? Because there's giant on the job. So see, you see on the spiritual warfare there, you gotta stand up. And how David looked, they say he didn't look well. Yeah, good. But I read he looked handsome. You know, and then he they said his skin looked different. It looked different because he was out in the sun, laying down in the pasture with the sheep watching. But then his brother, you might have someone in your own household, might just despise you a little bit because you are anointed, you see. So, but yet still, you qualify for the call. See, David was. He killed a bear. He killed a lion. He grabbed the bear by his beard, he said. That's what he told King Saul. King Saul feared the giant. David wanted to go out there, and King Saul tried to put him on the shield, but it was too heavy for him. David couldn't move around. His anointing was totally different. We got anointing that is totally different. Each one of us wore different. I can't do what you do. You can't do what I do. We can't do what Bishop do. We can't do what Mary do. See? But when we come together, we pass. Okay? I can't wear your garment. You can't wear my spiritual garment. See? Now, shield. I can't use your weapons, and you can't use my weapons. See, David had a slingshot. And I remember when I was a child, we used to make this slingshot. But it wasn't like David. But David, when Saul was looking at him, he just looked like, you want to need a shield. Mm. But scripture said, walk by faith, not by sight. David walked by faith. He was so mad at the giant. He wanted to just go out there and just kill him real quick. He said, wait a minute, let me go. I already killed the bear. Did you do something when you was young? Something extraordinary? And then you can do it today? You kill something? So look at that. That's part of your call. But you can do it today. I used to kill snake. Me and my brother used to go snake hunting and cut their heads off. I think that's why I get attacked. But I'm not afraid, see? I'm not afraid. I know what's coming. I know before you was thinking about this message. I know I'm going to get attacked. The last day, I got this phone call saying that my sister in Texas had COVID. Her husband had COVID. Then last night after sunset, found out my other sister, heart is beating funny. So she's in the hospital. I said, I don't care. I don't care. Shoot, that ain't gonna stop me. All right? So don't let nothing stop you. Don't let it stop you. But David came with God's word. When the giant was out there saying, I'm gonna do this. You dog. All these things. Your enemy would call me, saying the greatest things about you. Even in your dream. He come to you in your dream. It's a nightmare.
Yes, he does.
He'll wake you up.
Yes.
Like, wow. Okay?
Yes.
You see the war.
Yes.
You war in your dream. So I'm not afraid. So I'm thinking about Joshua. That you always remember God is with you.
Yes.
Okay. So you have to put on your spiritual war, wear a garment. Like I said, everybody's garment is different, but when it's with God, He wants you to have it like He said He wanted. Because He already knows, He already experienced Himself. So, with Saul, when he was in jail, his guard had this armor on, but it wasn't compared to the ephod that David wore, that Aaron wore. Saul was thinking about Israel. Okay, so this is what you have to have. If you want to defeat the enemy.
Ephesians 6, 11 and 12. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
All of these things. Don't try to fight. You got to come with the word. You got to find a scripture that works. Yahweh gave me a scripture in the dream. Joshua 1:9. Every time, I don't even get afraid. Like when I go home or even on the plane, anything, he said, have I told you? Again, remind you. I'm with you wherever you go.
All right.
You have to remember that.
Yes.
I'm with you forever.
Yes.
If I let the word mask or something, I still got my sword.
Yes.
Okay? I still got my sword. So don't be afraid. He is with you wherever you go. If you have to go through the hospital and have surgery, you put your seat. I am with you wherever you go.
Ephesians 6:13-15. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace.
You have to stand in a biblical time, Israel, man. You had to pull the garment up. There was a special way they had to wrap around when they say gird up, because you cannot run in a long coat. So there was a special way that you had to gird up. That's why I say gird up. So you want to stand. You don't want to be like, okay? You got to be ready. Okay? Sister Young know how to stand and be ready. And she be attentive. Fish know how to stand and be ready. Okay? Like how Yeshua told when he was in the Gethsemane Park. He told him, stay awake. But if you see, I wouldn't want my phone with me watching. You gotta watch. Keep your eyes open. Stand firm. You know, stand up. You level. And you're gonna be swift. Like how David spin all the way around. He was swift, like you know, you had to be know how to fight. And you come with God's word. Like I always tell both my son, I'm not gonna tell my enemy what I'm gonna do to him. I've never said that. But I can come with God's word. See, I can go that way. Okay. All right, so.
Ephesians 6:16-18. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplications in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints.
So you have to have that shield of faith.
Yes.
The Lord is my salvation. You see? You have a shield.
Yes.
You go, shoo. You keep going. Yes. You bother me. I don't care. I'm 63. I've heard a lot. I heard older. But Sister Young, I heard more than I have. Bishop, I heard more than I have. Mary, pastor. And some of you people that was raised by old folks, you know, I heard as much as the old folks I heard. Okay? But they would teach you how to war again. So you have to be pray. You say you were going up prayer language. You go speak in tongues. The devil won't know what he's saying. Your enemy won't know what you're saying on the job. It's okay to go get in your corner. You have a prayer room on the job. You know what can happen? You can do it. If I had a job, I should be doing it. And I might have some prayer warrior with me on the job.
Yeah.
That's how I would do it. Come on.
Yeshua tempted by Hasatan. Luke 4:1-4.
Okay, wait a minute. So with Yeshua, he gonna show you. He get the fine example before he went out to do the ministry. So he went into the the wilderness for 40 days. And also, you know, they say, like, once you get baptized, they say, you'll be brand new, you'll be filled with the Spirit. But Yeshua kept his Spirit always full of the Holy Ghost, full of the Ruach HaKodesh. So this is what the enemy tried to do to Yeshua while he was in the wilderness.
And Yeshua, being full of the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. And in those days he did not eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterward hungered. And the devil said unto him, If thou be the Son of God, command this stone that it be made bread. And Yeshua answered him, saying, It is written, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of the Lord.
So the enemy, real sneaky, he already knew Yeshua. They both was in heaven together. They just trying to trick him. And that's how the enemy, how he be knowing us. You know, in the Bible, how did the demon say, I know Paul, but who are you? The enemy knows me. I know you know me. Okay, so I'm not afraid. But I know that you cannot be open. You want a war, okay? Even though when Yeshua was fasting, you know, the enemy trying to come and mess with it. Like after he don't fast and everything did good, now he come for want to get you. So you always have to be aware. And how Yeshua was speaking to him. So he was using scriptures again. You see? So we have to use those scriptures. That's what's going to help. But we have to be doing too, living right. Don't just, I always say abusing the scripture, misusing it, but your lifestyle will not line up with the scripture, so you might get knocked out, okay? So.
Luke 4:5-8, and the devil, taking him up into a high mountain, shewed unto him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. And the devil said unto him, All this power will I give thee, and the glory of them, for that it is delivered unto me, and to whomsoever I will, I give it. If thou therefore wilt worship me, and shall be thine. And Yeshua answered and said unto him, Get thee behind me, Satan, for it is written, Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shall thou worship, shall thou serve.
So how's the time to have to say, I'll give you all the king. You know what people spread out in the world. There's your sheep's out there. No, this is not there. But yet and still we know that as a time, he has his own spiritual realm and darkness, evil. You see. But Yeshua kept saying, It is written. So this is what we have to say. Say it. Don't be embarrassed. Don't care if you attack through your mind, you still can say, I am a child of God. I am a mighty warrior. Don't you mess with me. Okay. Sometimes I tell my son, don't you mess with me. They know when I look at them a different way. Don't mess with me. Okay? They know. So with the enemy, you got to do something different. Okay, come with the scripture. Come with it. Tell them about what happened to those other fallen angels. Where are they? Because your day is coming, Hasatan. Remind him. Your day is coming. You're going to be looking for 1,000 years. Tell them that. Tell them. Your day is coming. I can't wait. Yeah. So enemy. We're going to read this right here. It is written, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angel, nor principality. So you got to come up with
this. Nor things to come, nor height, nor death, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
All right, let's go walk. Y'all ready? Thank you, Lord. Thanks for the Holy Spirit for being upon us. May we all be protected as we go out the doors. Thank you, and Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.